ஹாய் போவன், வணக்கம், குட் மார்னிங், சுப உதாசனா. வி ஆர் ப்ளீஸ் டு பார்ட்னர் டு த யூத் ஃபோரம் ஆன் கிளைமேட் சேஞ்ச் ஆர்கனைஸ் இன் கலபரேஷன் வித் லைக் அண்ட் ட்ரஸ்ட் ஃபார் த ஃபிஃப்த் கன்செகட்டிவ் இயர். திஸ் இவெண்ட் ஹேஸ் டிவலப் இன் டு அ லேண்ட்மார்க் இவெண்ட் இன் கிளைமேட் சேஞ்ச் ஆக்டிவிட்டி கேலண்டர் இன் ஸ்ரீலங்கா, ஆஸ் ஒன் விச் கேட்டர்ஸ் டு ப்ராடன் த யூத்ஸ் எங்கேஜ்மெண்ட், capacity building and awareness creation on climate change among youth through partnership, mentoring and empowerment. As a party to United Nations Framework Convention on Climate Change and the Paris Agreement, Sri Lanka is actively engaging taking climate action at national and local levels while contributing to the global process aimed at combating climate change. We as a country have an uphill task of facing the adverse impact of climate change, adapting to impacts of climate change while facing losses and damages already felt. This is very relevant to many sectors which are vital for the sustainable development of Sri Lanka. For example, the sectors of food security, water resources, biodiversity and forestry, and many more. Sri Lanka has identified key sectors and are focusing on climate action related to them through policies and plans, as well as projects that address climate risks and vulnerabilities. It is important that in developing climate policies and actions, we focus on the most vulnerable communities and ecosystems and ensure that the impact of climate change does not lead to aggravating existing socio-economic vulnerabilities as well. Sri Lanka is moving towards sustainable development while taking into consideration the key components related to climate change, including mitigation and adaptation actions. Additionally, we are working towards building resilience of communities, reducing carbon emissions, as well as accessing means of implementation, including finance, technology, and capacity building. 2020 is an important year. As a country, Sri Lanka is preparing to submit the review and updated nationally determined contribution to the United Nations Framework Convention on Climate Change, which aims to include ambitious and clear steps which indicate countries' commitment to scaling up climate action while ensuring sustainable development in the country. Stakeholder engagement, participation, inclusive process, and gender responsive actions are among some of the aspects which are focused through the reviewed NDCs. Among these key elements, youth engagement, education and capacity building, addressing climate risks, building evidence-based approaches for decision-making are highlighted. The engagement of youth in determining and implementing these NDCs is extremely important, as they are the future leaders who would take positive climate action forward. Youth can activate their contribution and leadership in their communities. Local authorities and provincial and family come together as a united network at national and international level to achieve the target of a climate resilient and sustainable world. The United Nations Framework Convention processes highlight this through different programs focusing on the engagement of youth, their empowerment, as well as focusing on climate education and skill development. In national policy and action related to climate change, Climate Change Secretariat of Sri Lanka under the Ministry of Environment aims to incorporate these aspects and provide maximum opportunities for youth to be engaged in climate action at all levels. I would like to take this opportunity as the Director Climate Change Secretariat of Sri Lanka to thank all contributors for putting together such a global scale event in Sri Lanka despite the COVID-19 pandemic situations and the COVID restrictions, and bring all of us together for the fifth year consecutive to engage and empower youth in contributing to climate action, and wish all the participants a constructive and productive participation for all sessions of the Youth Forum on Climate Change 2020. I thank you very much.